and you can get the total. This is the total. This is the total potential.This is the total potential from a system of point charge. Okay, this is the same principle as in the electric field. Same principle as in the electric field. And we follow the same step.When you are able to calculate the electric field from point charge, the next question is that how can we calculate the electric field from a continuous distribution of charge? Now it's not point charge. Again, the formula like this can be used only for the point charge.It's like a Coulomb law. You can use the Coulomb law only for the point charge. You cannot use it for in general. So, if you have the system of point charge, you can use this expression. But if the charge distribute uniformly, we have to do something similar to when we calculate the electric field. Okay, but this is much simpler. When you haveThe continuous charge distribution, for example, if you have a charge, a distribution of charge here, okay, and you want to calculate the electric fieldelectric potential at this point. So far, we only have the expression for the discrete charge. So what can we do in this situation? It's straightforward. It's very similar to when we calculate the electric field. The way is that you divide itThe region to be the small element, to be a small element, and each element has to be small enough to be considered as a point. Okay, each element has to be small enough to be considered as a point.And then you calculate the electric potential of each element. I may write it as a delta V. Delta V is the electric potential of each element. And then you sum it to get the total potential. Okay?To sum it to get the total potential. So the idea is very similar to the calculation of the electric field. It's very similar. If you have the continuous charge, you divide into the small element. It has to be small enough to be considered as a point, and then you calculate.The potential from each element. But when I told you that this is much simpler because now the electric potential is a scalar, right? It's a scalar. So you don't have to worry about the vector property.Because it is a scalar, and when you do the integration, when you do the integration, you don't have to worry that what is the component, x component, y component, c component, radial component, whatever component, because it don't have the potential is not scalar, so it don't have component like that. You have only one value. So this is very very simple to calculate the electric potential. Let's see a simple example. Again, we start with the most simple. The charge distribute on a thin ring. In this situation, we have a very thin ring, and when we say that it is thin, it means that we can use, we can approximately think that the ring is a line, is a circle, is a line. We cannot have the real one-dimensional line in real world. It will have some thickness, right? But if the thickness is very small, that's why we say that it is a thin ring. So if the thickness of the ring is very small, we can assume that it is just a one-dimensional line, one-dimensional circle. Okay? And from that, if we want to calculate the potential at this point, the way to do that is that we divide this ring to be many small elements like this, and each element has to be small enough to be considered as a point. Okay, so we can think that, for example, at this point, this element is a point on the ring. Okay, and the next step is that we calculate the electric potential of this element at point P. But since we assume that the charge here is a point, so we can use the formula of the potential from a point charge to do this task. Okay, so if the charge on this element is dQ, so we have that dV. Again, when I write down like a dV, you don't have to worry much. It's just I just want to write the element or the value of the potential that comes from one element, and I use the symbol dV, just that. Okay, it has some meaning in calculus, but for now, for physics, it is just the mean that this is the electric potential from one element, just that, nothing more. Okay, and since this element, we assume that this element is small enough to be a point, so we have that dV is equal to the dQ over 4 pi epsilon 0 r, where r is the distance, okay? R is the distance from this element to point P. R is the distance from this element to point P, okay? And when we know the electric potential from one element, the next step is we sum up the electric potential from every element to get the total potential. So it means that we calculate the electric potential from this element, from this element, from this element, and we do the and we sum the electric potential from every element on the ring. And we again we use the technique of the calculus, the integral. So we have that V is equal to the integral of dV is equal to the integral of dQ over 4 pi epsilon 0 r. Okay? The integral here is nothing. It's just a summation. So its meaning, the meaning is very